Now we will discuss motion of a car on a banked road. So in this discussion, the understanding the diagram is very, very important. Let us draw a very big diagram. Say I have a banked road here. Say the angle of banking is theta. So here I have a car. Weight of the car is always acting downwards. Let me take it as mg. When you are taking a turn on a banked road, if you increase the speed, then the car will be thrown outwards. So therefore, frictional force will act in this direction. This is the direction of frictional force. Frictional force is always parallel to the surface of contact. This is surface of contact. Frictional force is parallel to the surface of contact. And what about normal reaction? Normal reaction is perpendicular to the surface of contact. Normal reaction is always perpendicular to the surface of contact. Frictional force is parallel to the surface of contact. Now this angle here will be equal to theta, because this is the horizontal road and this is the normal reaction. If this road is given a banking of angle theta, then normal reaction also bends an angle theta, correct? No? So here this is the horizontal road and this is the normal reaction, perpendicular. Now what we have done, we have given a banking of angle theta, okay? So therefore normal reaction also bends through an angle theta. So if I imagine a right angle triangle here, okay, so this will be n cos theta, okay? And this component, if this is adjacent side, so this is n cos theta, this is opposite side. So therefore, length of this here will be n sine theta, or length of this component here will be n sine theta. Okay. Now, this is a frictional force. So if you imagine a right angle triangle here, this angle also will be equal to theta. Therefore, this will be opposite side. So this vector will be equal to F sine theta. So this will be equal to F cos theta, or one component of friction is here. So that will be F cos theta. Okay. But the car is moving like this in a circular path. So somewhere here there will be center. Okay. Centripetal force is towards the center. So who is responsible for centripetal force? One is F cos theta and the other is N sin theta. Whereas in the case of motion of a car on a horizontal road, only frictional force was responsible. If you remember, motion of a car on a horizontal road, normal reaction was acting upwards. Frictional force alone was responsible for centripetal force. But now what happened? The normal reaction, one component of the normal reaction is helping to produce centripetal force. So therefore, so the centripetal force, who is responsible for centripetal force? One is F cos theta, one is F cos theta plus N sin theta. So mv square by r equal to, like that, F cos theta plus N sin theta, because this is the center of the path, okay? Then if you look at the diagram, so at equilibrium, vertically the car is not going up or the car is not going down. So upward forces equal to downward forces at equilibrium. So therefore I can write N cos theta is equal to mg plus F sin theta. Mg plus F sin theta. I name this as equation number 1 and this as equation number 2. Now what we'll do, we'll substitute the value of friction. We know that maximum value of static friction. So now this is not required for this derivation. A maximum value of static friction or limiting friction is mu s into n. We will consider the maximum friction. So what happens? N cos theta n cos theta is equal to mg plus mu s into n sin theta. Simplifying further, I'll bring this term to LHS. What happens? N into cos theta minus mu s sin theta is equal to mg, and then I'll write an equation for n. So therefore n is equal to mg divided by cos theta minus mu s sin theta. Now I'll substitute this value of n in equation number 1. So what happens? Now equation number 1 implies mv square by r minus f cos theta. What is f cos theta? F in the place of f, I'll write mu s into n into cos theta equal to n sin theta. I'll simplify this equation a little. This becomes mv square by r is equal to n into sin theta plus mu s cos theta. Mu s cos theta, because I have brought this term to RHS. Now I'll substitute the value of n here. Okay, I'll substitute the value of n. So what happens? Mv square by r. So here I can write in the place of v, I can write v maximum, because I have taken the maximum value of static friction. Here. So corresponding to maximum value of static friction, the velocity with which you can turn will be maximum. So I'll take mv maximum square by r is equal to, what is n? N is equal to mg divided by here cos theta minus mu s sin theta into sin theta plus mu s cos theta. So let me simplify this a little. So what happens? So let me divide the entire equation by cos theta. If I divide the entire equation by cos theta, what happens? So mv square by r is equal to mg into, so here sin theta by cos theta will be tan theta plus mu s into cos theta by cos theta will be equal to 1 divided by cos theta by cos theta is 1 minus mu s into sin theta by cos theta is tan theta. Now this m and m gets cancelled, so v square is equal to rg into tan theta plus mu s divided by 1 minus mu s tan theta, 1 minus mu s tan theta. Or v is equal to maximum speed. Here I should write maximum speed. Maximum speed with which a car can take a turn is equal to square root of rg into tan theta plus mu s divided by 1 minus mu s tan theta. Now we will discuss a special case. What if friction is absent? If friction is absent, then what happens? The value of mu s is equal to 0, correct? No? The value of mu s is equal to 0. When mu s is equal to 0, so denominator, so 0 into tan theta will be 0. So denominator will be 1. So this mu s will become equal to 0. So it will be equal to, v maximum will be equal to square root of rg tan theta. This speed we call it as optimum speed. This is called optimum speed. If you move in this particular speed, the wear and tear of the tires will be very, very minimum. So what we can observe is, even though the friction is absent, you can take a turn in a banked road. Whereas if you compare this in the case of horizontal road, in the case of horizontal road, what is the expression for maximum, V maximum? V maximum equal to square root of mu rg, correct? No, square root of mu s into rg. If mu s is zero, if friction force is not there, then V maximum is zero. What does it mean? In the horizontal road, if there is no friction, you cannot take a turn. But in the case of banked road, even in the absence of frictional force, you can take a turn. So this is actual final equation. So this is the maximum velocity with which you can take a turn. Okay, so this is the equation for optimum speed. So that is if friction is absent in the banked road, maximum speed with which you can take a turn is square root of rg tan theta.